Hi, I'm Tallis Barker from waterfasting.org, and today we're going to be talking about working out while fasting. This is a topic which comes up quite a lot on the website. People ask whether it's okay if they work out while they're fasting. And unlike a lot of topics, which can really depend on the individual person, the individual fast, this issue is something which has a very clear-cut answer. And I'll give you the answer right now, right at the beginning. Do not plan on working out during your fast, because it's only going to end up injuring your health. Now, I think it's really important to understand why we shouldn't be working out, and that's what we're going to spend the next few minutes looking at. More than anything else, a fast really should be about slowing down. And that's what I'm going to do right now, because I have a feeling this picture's pretty bouncy at the moment. So yeah, during a fast, you want to slow down. And this is pretty simple, you see, because even if it doesn't look like you're doing a lot of energetic stuff from the outside, on the inside, tons of energy is being put into cleansing and healing. And the thing is, if you're expending a lot of intense physical energy on working out, running, going to the gym, or what have you, you're not going to be able to get the most out of the energy inside you, which should be dedicated to cleansing and healing. I think there are several reasons why, nevertheless, it's obvious, right? We should be slowing down. But there are reasons why people resist the obvious. One of them is addiction to exercise and the endorphins, of course, which we feel while exercising. And as much as they can make us feel great in everyday life, things are going to be very different while fasting. And as much as fasting really deals with addiction on so many levels, this is another example of it. This is a chance to free yourself from your addictions to endorphins. Beyond this, though, maybe even stronger in influencing our drive to work out, at least in some shape or form while fasting, is the fear of losing muscle mass. You know, in everyday life, we've been working out really hard, been concentrating on building up muscle tone or muscle mass or whatever you want. And of course, if you fast, then you're going to lose some of that. But it's a completely erroneous thought to think that working out during fasting is going to somehow help you in some way. In fact, the exact opposite is true. Working out while fasting is going to make you lose even more muscle mass. Now, we need to take a look at the mechanics of how you build muscle in everyday life. When you are working out, when you've done an intense or a prolonged workout, the reason you end up building muscle is because that workout, through its intensity or its duration, is actually creating micro muscle damage on a cellular level. And then the body responds to that by building extra muscle tissue. It's kind of like there's an internal logic which says, okay, well, if I was damaged in my current state, given the activity that I just was doing, then surely I need more muscle to prevent that from happening next time around. It's a little bit also like what happens when you prune trees or bushes in your garden. So pruning is obviously a great way to encourage new growth for plants. And it's basically the same here when we're working out in our own bodies. But there's a huge difference in terms of what's going on in our bodies when we're fasting and when we're in everyday life. Because what happens is, when we're fasting, we're not in a kind of building new cell phase. No, it's the exact opposite. The body, through its healing and cleansing emphasis, is dedicated much more towards cleaning up old cells. And so what's going to happen is, if you do work out, if you do get that level of micro damage to muscles, then all that's going to happen is you're going to do the damage. Your body's going to clean that damage out, but it's not going to replace those damaged muscle tissues with extra new cells. And as a result, you're going to lose muscle tissue and therefore muscle mass. So it's not looking very good, is it, for really dedicated athletes and everyone who's addicted to their endorphins. But the great thing about fasting is that our body takes care of us. Yes, we're going to lose a little bit of muscle mass during the fast, but after the fast, as part of the overall hormonal reset that takes place throughout our body produces much greater quantities of growth hormone. And that growth hormone just makes it a whole lot easier to build muscle tissue afterwards. And you don't even really have to do any extra work to gain it back. It's going to happen by itself. You may be aware, of course, that growth hormone is actually a doping agent, which unfortunately is used by some athletes. But in this case, it's totally natural, totally safe. This is just the way the body works. And it's a miracle, really, of the way that our body just knows what to do. You don't even need to worry about going on a high-protein diet after the fast. In fact, high-protein diets are unfortunately one way which you can end up in problems with refeeding if you try and give yourself too much protein too soon. Okay, so what's okay and what's not okay in terms of working out or physical activity while we're fasting? Well, in terms of what's okay, gentle walking, stretching is absolutely fine. In fact, it's really good for you because gentle movement is going to help to flush out toxins. Just by raising your heart and lung level a little bit, it's going to help to cleanse you. And I'd highly recommend that for anyone who's doing a fast. And more generally speaking, anything which simply feels comfortable, if it feels good, is probably good for you. In terms of what's not okay, you absolutely, positively want to avoid anything which brings you close to the so-called anaerobic threshold. Now, the anaerobic threshold is the point beyond which your heart and lungs cannot provide enough oxygen to the cells, which is being demanded by muscles during times of physical activity. The problem with anaerobic exercise, or anything which really approaches it, is that ketosis alone cannot do the job. When you're doing low intensity activity, ketosis can pretty much take care of everything. But the moment you come close to that anaerobic threshold, the only way you can gain enough energy to do so is by burning carbs. And since your glycogen stores are going to be exhausted during a fast, how does this happen? Very simple. Just like on day two of a fast, where your primary source of fuel is muscle, because muscle can be broken down into carbohydrates from where it can be burnt immediately. So approaching that anaerobic threshold is going to cause increased muscle loss. Don't do it. And more generally, anything which just feels uncomfortable, like you're pushing yourself beyond your natural capacity, should be avoided. Anything which gives you sore muscles the next day is a sign you've pushed yourself too far. And again, the problem with sore muscles is that it's muscle damage. And again, because you're fasting, your body's going to clean up those damaged muscles, but it's not going to replace them. Good example of this, Mahatma Gandhi, who famously did a couple of 21-day fasts, especially in terms of bringing public awareness to the plight of India under English colonial rule. On one of his 21-day fasts, he basically walked from village to village to village. And as much as walking normally should be absolutely within the reach of anyone doing a fast, you can imagine that under the baking Indian sun, this was like a hard workout every day. And in the end, he did lasting damage. He could not walk properly afterwards. And so you definitely want to avoid that. And finally, one other suggestion to be especially careful. As I mentioned this day two thing before, you want to be really careful on day two not to push things too hard, because this is the day after which your glycogen stores have run out. In other words, your carbohydrate-based energy reserves. And it's before ketosis has really had a chance to kick in 100%. So It's a totally natural thing that the body does turn to burning muscle. We're only talking about a couple of ounces here. It's not going to break the bank in terms of your muscle stores. Nothing to worry about. But obviously, there's no point pushing things if you don't have to. Okay, so when is it okay to work out? First of all, day one of a fast, or if you're only doing a 24-hour fast, is absolutely fine, because during those first 24 hours, you do have glycogen stores, and as a result, you'll just be working on them. If you're doing a longer fast, though, a lot's going to depend on the length of the fast in terms of when it's safe to begin working out again. So what you have to realize is that, yes, growth hormone increases after a fast, but totally understandably, the body's priority is not muscle. It's going to be first to rebuild your inner organs. So, you know, your liver, your kidneys have been working really overtime, lymphatic system, immune system, all that. So it's going to devote its energy to working on them first. And this takes time. After it's completed that process, then it's going to move to your muscles, at which point it's totally okay to work out again. Now, as far as I know, there haven't been any really scientific studies on how this works out. All I can tell you is my own experience. And generally speaking, what I find is that the time it takes to presumably rebuild my muscle, because I can feel when when I'm doing damage to myself, trial and error basically over the years, that basically you need to wait approximately 50% of the length of the fast after the end of the fast before you start working out again. So what this means is that, let's say you've done a 3-day fast. You want to wait at least one, maybe two days before you start working out. If you've done a 7-day fast, you want to wait 3 or 4 days, and so forth. And one other thing which is really worth taking into consideration is that this is the beginning point when it's really okay to start working out again. I would really, really recommend going easy on your first workout, because you may find that you're still going to get sore muscles afterwards. It's not going to feel right. But if you are careful, then I think you'll find that in a relatively short period of time, you feel normal again. For me, that tends to be about the length of the fast itself after the end of the fast, when I'm feeling more or less I'm at my regular fitness levels. Now, this is where the good stuff happens. It's from this point where I find that I just feel great. My performance increases. So, for instance, in terms of running, my running times naturally decrease without me really having to work for them. I confess I'm a bit of a push-up maniac, and I can end up doing more push-ups without me having to work for it. I find about a 5% increase in performance in general. So there is light at the end of the tunnel. It is worth waiting to get the goodness out of it. And if you do, I think you should just enjoy your fast, slow down, and then enjoy working out afterwards.